Yo, what is good, everybody? Welcome back to another video. So 21 days, guys. By the time you're watching this, I think it's gonna be only 20 days until the keto cut is over. So I'm gonna give you a physique update on how I'm looking. And so enough talking, I'm gonna put the camera down, so let's do it. Okay, guys, so that is the updated physique so far. Everything's coming along, getting leaner by the day. Fatigue levels are still low, but again, we're fighting through that, guys. We're doing a lot better. So, talked to my coach, you know, talked to him. He saw the video. He knows how I was feeling crappy. So he made an update to the plan just for today, guys, and I'm gonna film it because it's gonna be interesting. I think the way I wanna film today and tomorrow's and show you how different these meal plans are. So in today's meal plan, guys, we're gonna have, I believe, and I'll go over everything, but I believe it's 150 grams of white rice with every single meal. And there's a damn fly in it. Oh, flies drive me crazy. So anyways, yes, it's gonna be technically a high carb day, almost in a way, because normally when I do have my carbs, they're normally pre-workout. So normally I'll have about 100 grams of white rice before a workout, which is roughly 20, 25 grams of carbs for a workout. Easily burn up through that and I'm back ketosis that night. Well, for today, I'm gonna be having white rice with every single meal and raw honey. So we'll talk a little bit more about that, but I just wanted to let you know what you're diving into. Less than 20 days of the keto cut, things are gonna get really interesting, guys. Things are gonna get really interesting. But before we start this video, guys, I just wanna let you know that if you're watching this right now, you know what that means. That means that you woke up stronger, that means that you are winning. So are you stressed? All your problems, can't face you, can't face me, because you and I are already winning, fam.
Mina, what you eating, girlfriend? You always eating. You are always eating, my little garbage disposal. And then we got this little one right here. Say hi. Say, what's up, everyone? Oh, you're dizzy. Oh my God, so dizzy. My little Lola's so dizzy. You're being silly, mamas. You're being silly. Okay, guys, so we're gonna have the first meal of the day, and when we have the first meal, I'm gonna go over my meal plan. You guys may be a little freaked out when you see what's on the meal for today, so let's get ready to have meal number one. You ready?
Yeah.
All right, everybody, so for meal number one, we got 5 servings of egg whites, and we have 150 grams of white rice. Yes, I know, guys, I know a lot of you freaking out, like, Logan, I thought this was the keto cut, what are you doing? It's all part of the plan, don't panic, Hispanic, everything's gonna be okay. So let's go over the meal plan before we dive into this. So for meal number one today, guys, it's gonna be 5 egg whites, obviously 150 grams of white rice with coffee. I already had my coffee, no creamer in it. And then we have 1/2 teaspoon of Redmond's Real Salt. For meal number two, we have 4 ounces of ground beef cooked with, you guessed it, 150 grams of white rice. For our pre-workout meal, which is 90 minutes prior to our workout, it's gonna be 4 ounces of chicken, 150 grams of white rice, and 20 grams of organic raw honey. Woo, this should be a fun workout. And post-workout, we got 4 ounces of lean protein. So we can either go with like turkey, we can go with chicken, or a lean ground beef. And we're gonna have that with 150 grams of white rice. For meal number five, we have 5 ounces of steak or lean ground beef with 113 grams of white rice. And then finally, for meal number six, which is always my favorite meal, we have 1 serving of yogurt plus 1 Heca bar plus 150 grams of cucumber. Boom. Wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. So that is gonna be the meal plan today, guys. When we meet up with Ross a little bit later for our workout, if you guys wanna know why he's doing this, why we're going through this, I'll let him explain it. But again, guys, it's just to change things up. I think my metabolism needed a boost, maybe needed just a little reset. You guys understand, like, I've been doing the same meal plan for a really long time. Yes, I've been doing targeted keto, and a lot of you think that 100 grams of white rice before a workout is a lot. It's really not, guys. It's really only 20 to 25 grams of carbs. You're gonna burn right through that through the workout, and plus I would have cardio after my workout, so I would really burn through that. So it's really not a lot. So for the most part, my meal plan has been very consistent, and I have not had a true cheat day. This whole prep, guys, no pizza, no ice cream, no beer, nothing, guys. It has been very, very strict nutrition, and so my body has definitely felt the effects of that. And so I think Ross is probably doing this just to give my metabolism like a boost, a reset, and go from there. But again, one thing I do love about Ross's coaching is that he doesn't take all these studies. What he does is he puts you through your own study. And so all this stuff that we do, like the targeted keto, having the watermelon and pineapple that one night, checking ketosis the next morning, going through these sprints and doing these refeed days, these are all experiments on myself. So no study, no experiment that we look on online. Those studies, I don't know who they did those on. I don't know what type of people they were. Were they even doing keto? Were they not doing keto? What were the health issues? Like a bunch of stuff, right? Just do a study on myself. Do a study on yourself and see if it works or not. Take all that data and learn from there and grow from there. So I'm hungry, guys. I'm ready to eat this. We'll see you on meal number two.
Okay, so as you can see, I've already prepped for this day. I already got all my rice made for the day right here. So just need to warm it up. And then I got my next meal, which is gonna be some ground beef in here. Okay, so we got some chicken in here. Okay, so we got some chicken and we got some ground beef in here. The cauliflower rice is at the bottom, but I'm gonna try to scoop that out. But that's gonna be the next meal. Some ground beef and rice.
All right, guys, so here is meal number two. Now, I didn't have enough ground beef, so I just substituted with some chicken. Anyways, everything's supposed to be lean today as far as meats-wise. Main focus is carbs. But before I dive into this, guys, I wanna tell you thank you. Everybody who sent positive, encouraging energy comments and last video, as you guys know, I had like a kind of a mental breakdown, kind of a breaking point of the keto cut in the last video. And I just need to like vent and just really talk about it, discuss about it, how I was feeling emotionally, you know, physically. Obviously, I feel so much better now, but the positive, encouraging messages that I got from you guys, just like, I can't tell you enough. Thank you, every single one of you. Yes, yes, I'm talking to you. Yes, you. Thank you for sending me the positive messages. I definitely needed it. It helped push me over that hump, kind of get over that feeling. I'm like, you know what? I got this. I got this. People believe in me. People got my back. And I can't thank you enough. It means so much to me. It means so much to my family. So thank you, guys. Thank you for help motivating me. Thank you for sticking with me through this whole keto journey that started, seems like years ago. But thank you, guys. I truly, truly appreciate it. I love you guys.
What you eating?
Me?
Yes, what are you eating? Where's your pants? Where are your shorts at? Where are your shorts? You wanna go outside?
Okay, guys, I have to show you something. Something I'm really, really excited about. So for those of you who don't know me, or you know, you're new to the channel, before this whole fitness thing started, and I used to talk about this a lot, before this whole fitness thing started, my passion was motorcycles. I absolutely love motorcycles, but unfortunately that was one of the biggest reasons why I was overweight. I would literally just drive my motorcycle on all my free times, go from like fast food place to bars and this and that, and create a really bad habit, and you know, I got really big. Then I got into fitness and I just didn't have any more time to ride, because now all my spare time was at the gym, eating healthy, nutrition, YouTube. And it's been obviously a couple of years. I had kids and just wasn't able to ever get back on a bike, but it's something that I've always missed. And every time I'd hear a bike like pass, I'm like, oh man, I miss bike riding. Like, I miss having a motorcycle. And it was finally time. Yep, it was finally time. So yes, you know what I'm about to show you.
Look at this. So here it is, guys. I have not had a motorcycle in years. It's literally been years, but it was finally time to get one. So right here, you're looking at a Yamaha Raider right here. It's got the custom Bantenhein pipes, as you can hear, and I'm about to turn it on and let you hear it, but this is an absolute beauty. Beauty, all chromed out and pristine conditioned. Huge, huge motor, guys. Huge motor. It's a 1900cc motor. And yes, I am very happy with this bike. And yes, guys, I'm gonna wear a helmet. And yes, Crystal is very upset. She's very upset. But hey, man, I gotta get a toy. She got her new car. You know, she's got a bunch of things. Like, daddy needed something, all right? Daddy needed to get something for his own, so had to get this bike. But I am very happy with it, pleased. And yes, don't worry, for all you mothers, everyone watching, Goody Bee's gonna be safe. Don't worry, I'll be very safe. Gonna wear a helmet, not gonna drive fast. But yeah, here it is. This is my new baby right here. Okay, you guys know I had to do it. I had to do it, guys. Hayes County, this is the first time opening up like in 2 months. And you know your boy Goody Bee's had to come support. So shout out to Hayes County, the best barbecue in Texas. If you're ever in the Central Texas area, especially San Marcos, I better see your ass here at Hayes County Barbecue. So let's go inside and let's get some food. All right, guys, so here we are for meal number three. And like I said, I had to go to Hayes County, guys. Hayes County just opened up today. And anytime you can show local support to local companies, you know, that's very important. Of course, obviously, like McDonald's and Burger King and all these big corporations, they're not hurting for money. It's these small local businesses that are. So when Hayes County finally opened back up, you know I had to go. And so it fits my meal plan. So on the next meal, I have 4 ounces of chicken. So here's my half chicken right here. I'm just gonna peel off some of the skin, which I normally don't do. Or I could also go turkey as well, 4 ounces of turkey. The main purpose of the meat is it's gotta be super, super lean. And then we have 150 grams of white rice, obviously, but we're gonna add 20 grams of raw honey. Raw honey, now I have seen people do raw honey as their TKD workout, pre-workout meal, so targeted keto, guys. Instead of having white rice, they'll do raw honey. My good buddy Danny Vega does this, so I'm pretty excited about this. I mean, who doesn't like raw honey? I mean, I think this is gonna taste really good. What I think I'm gonna do is mix it in the rice and the chicken, so this should be a really delicious pre-workout meal. So raw honey, rice, chicken, let's go. So this is actually pretty darn good, guys. The honey, it just gives it like this really sweet taste. And then the extra salt, it's like a sweet, salty meal. Like, I don't know how to explain it, but it's a really good pre-workout meal. One thing though, I wanted to talk to you guys about. So I just launched my new website. I'm not even sure if I talked about this yet, but I just launched my new website. So as you guys know, over the years, I've been doing the ketogenic diet since 2013. I've come up with many, many programs, keto hacks, keto secrets, everything I've learned from 2013 and doing the ketogenic now, whether that's targeted keto, cyclical keto,
or just going straight hardcore, strict keto, I have many, many programs with meal plans and workout plans, and everything is available on my website, guys. So when you go to my website and you sign up, you will have access to all my programs, and additional programs will be coming. Also, you'll have access to private videos. So I've made videos for my YouTube channel and for my programs that only people who are on my website, people who have access to my programs, have access to these videos, not the general public. So you can't just go, unless you have a special link to that video, you won't be able to see it. So when you sign up, you'll be able to have access to those videos as well. Plus, many more things are coming. And guys, I still have a bunch of protein boxes of Mammoth Fuel Bars. So if you guys want a box of Mammoth Fuel Bars, birthday cake flavor, which is really good, keto friendly, sign up today and you'll get a box of free protein bars and have access to all my programs, guys. It's a really good website. I've been working on it for many, many months and I'm super excited to finally announce it, guys. So make sure you go sign up. Link will be in the description below, guys. Access, lifetime access to all my programs, plus free protein bars. Who doesn't want that, guys? So make sure you go sign up today. All right, guys, you know what time it is. You know what time it is. We are in the Sweet Iron Boom Paradise. And I gotta show you something, because the veins are already popping. So let's see if you guys can see this. Let's see if you guys can see this. Yeah, you'll be upside down, but just to be able to see. Look at that. All right, Ross, so 150 grams of carbs with all my meals today.
150 grams of rice.
God dang, why do I always say that? I'm wondering now. I'm gonna have to go back. I'm gonna have to go back in the videos and realize that every time I say that, I'm just gonna have to put this clip, that little snippet. Okay, 150 grams of white rice with every single meal. I'm sure people are gonna ask, why is Ross making you do that? Why are you making me do that?
Right? Yeah,
like, why are you forcing me to do this?
So, I had Logan the past 3 to 5 days, I had him deplete a lot. So he made a video, maybe a Sunday, the one I wanna quit. He was struggling real bad. Low energy, low food, high cardio. That was all planned. So my plan was to deplete his body of any glycogen whatsoever. So he wasn't eating rice at that time. He was pretty low calorie, low fats, and low proteins. And then my plan was to deplete him, and then give him a traditional or an actual refeed. So when I hear refeed, I hear a lot of people use it so incorrectly, like, oh, refeed is eating burger and fries and whatever you want, or it's just a big meal of carbs or anything like that. A refeed is when you deplete your body of everything and you just eat protein, a little bit of protein and a lot of carbs. So that's what he did today. He had egg whites and rice for meal one. Meal two was it beef and rice?
It was chicken.
Chicken and rice, chicken, so rice. Two sources of lean protein.
And then another chicken.
Another chicken meal. But the pre-workout was 150 grams of rice and 20 grams of organic honey, which was the kicker. So both are pretty fast acting carbs, and he's got veins all over.
Yeah, look at this. I'm just standing holding the camera. Like we're not even like.
So what's crazy is that, yeah.
Woo!
So today he's gonna eat nothing but proteins and carbs for one day. He should have a really good workout here, and I told him a couple days ago he's gonna be really, really hungry. So he's gonna have a giant metabolic response, which is good. We wanna break through any plateaus. And then Saturday, he's gonna eat nothing but protein and fats. So what the fats are gonna do is, A, his water's already high, his sodium's high, his carbs are gonna be high from today, so he's gonna have glycogen buildup. Now we're gonna add in fats on Saturday. And what that's gonna do is gonna help keep the glycogen in his muscles, which will keep him fuller, better training performance, better results. So that's what we're doing today, and we'll see how he does.
So there you go, guys. That is the game plan from the coach himself. I'm excited to get this workout. And as you can see, we obviously don't record a lot of our workouts, but Ross knows, like last week, the workouts were trash for me. Like he was having to like constantly be on me. Go, come on, what are you doing? Push yourself. I have a feeling that's not gonna be the case today, so let's get to it.
Nice. Go, Logan. Good. Flip your wrist. Yep. Yep. Yes.
Oh, shoot. Oh. Oh, my God.
Yeah, good. Just go through front double, front spread.
Okay.
Back double, back spread. Yeah, legs, come on. Good, front spread. Good. Breathe. Stomp. Good. Stomp with the left leg. Left leg. Breathe out. Good. Back double. Nice. Good. Big chest, big chest, big chest. Good. Harder. Good. Relax. Back double. Back spread. Pull it. Row. Good. Nice. Good. Let's do, we haven't done this one. Hands. Nope. Let's go. Okay. Or shit. Yep. Good. Logan. Nice chest. Good. All right, hands overhead, abdominal and thighs. Legs out, both legs. Good. Good, switch legs. Same thing. Good.
Oh gosh. That's the posing. We normally will do that about twice a week. Knock out some poses, really get me in conditioning. Now, yes, I understand. I'm not getting ready for a show, but I still want to go through the process of getting ready for a show. And that's what you do towards the, well, you're supposed to really be doing it all through prep, but especially towards the end, locking down, really conditioning, going through the routine over and over again. So when you do step on stage, you're not gassed out. It's something that you're used to, because what people don't understand, I could go up there with the best package and my conditioning is shit. And I go up on that stage and I can't hold any poses and the judges are just gonna laugh. I'm like, that guy's not ready. I don't care how he looks. He didn't condition right. He didn't come in here mentally prepared to do these poses. He's out, and that'd be the last thing I'd wanna do. And like I said, if America and the world opens back up sometime in the fall, who knows, maybe I'll jump into a show and I'm used to it. I already know what it's gonna take. There's nothing new. It's not like, hey Ross, why are we doing this? Like, no, he's putting me through everything I need to do as if I was getting ready for a show. So conditioning, posing, everything. And one last thing, while Ross and I were working out, he had one other point he wanted to make about the carb refeed day.
Yeah, so as you saw in the intro, and he may play it in another clip during the later of the video, he was freaking ripped, crazy popped, veins everywhere, looking scary, crazy. So like I prefaced in the little intro thing, he's super depleted, super depleted. And all we did was give him high carbohydrate, dense meals. And what that did, it elicited a response. And when you're super depleted, you're gonna be ultra sensitive to those sort of factors. And that goes with everything: water, sleep, salt, carbs, sugar, fats, everything. So if you're gonna try this at, you know, on your own, you may not be in a position where you're super sensitive to those things, and you may not get the same results. But so we depleted them really hard, and that's why we got those sort of crazy effects.
Yeah, looking like I had lightning in me, man. Yeah.
Lightning bolts, I like it, I like it.
And so here's the meal. This is meal number 4, post-workout. We got what? We got 4 ounces of chicken in here. We got 150 grams of rice. And then what's the sauce? What's in the sauce,
Let's
guys?
Let's see what we got here. Okay, so we got Asian glaze, which is a roasted garlic ginger sauce. Oh, it's really good. Sriracha maple vinaigrette. You can buy that online, www.thegainsbakery.com. And then a light drizzle of chipotle aioli, or is that yum yum sauce?
Chipotle
aioli, which we are going to soon ship. Nice. And then is that cilantro sriracha?
Yeah.
And then a spicy cilantro sauce with a little bit of everything bagel seasoning.
Dude, oh, let's go. Let's go, guys. Don't be jealous.
What did you make me?
Pie.
That's a pie? That doesn't look like a pie to me. That looks like a magnet with crushed peppers in it.
That pie in the pie. There's a pie in the white.
Oh, okay. All right, guys. So I'm having my last kind of like full meal before tonight's dessert. Lola's copying everything I say. I'm having, obviously, guys, 150 grams of white rice with 4 ounces of lean meat. I went with turkey. This is a turkey I had left over from Hays County. And this is our last meal before having dessert. My papa. Good. Yeah, you can't have any because I waited already.
Yeah.
You're getting so big, mama. You're getting so big.
Dad, it's not
going
to work
good
for you. It's for me
doing
this.
Oh, really? Really? Give me a kiss. Are you watching TV or are you going to give me a kiss? I love you. Okay, guys, now on to the final and last meal of the night. This is my favorite. So we're going to have one protein yogurt right here. Well, this is YQ protein yogurt. It's the best yogurt you can get. I get mine at H-E-B. I'm not sure where else they sell it, but this is by far the best yogurt you can get. Most yogurts are packed with a bunch of sugar, and this is the only one I found that doesn't have a lot of sugar. So yeah, macros really good. And then what I do is I like to chop up a Hecka bar. This is like my new favorite Hecka bar flavor, guys. As you know, Hecka bar has many flavors. I got like chocolate, peanut butter, blueberry, macadamia nut, but this white chocolate raspberry is my absolute favorite. I'm telling you guys, you need to get a box. I promise you, absolutely love it. Use my discount code GoodyBeats to save yourself 10% off. And then we have 150 grams of cucumbers. And that's pretty much it for the macros. What? Go say hello? Come say hello? What? You don't want to say hello? What's the matter, mama? What's the matter, my baby? Oh, you got boo boo? You kiss it? Feel better?
I fell
down. Oh, you fell down. Oh, my baby. You hurt yourself. You kiss it. So, anyways, guys, that's going to be the last meal of the night. We'll catch up with you a little bit later. Let me go kiss Lolo's boo boo and see where she fell. Come on. All right, everybody, so we're gonna wrap up this video. So before we close out, I kind of want to give like a recap of everything, how I'm feeling and how today went. So I didn't get to add up all the macros, but I did tell you everything that was on the meal plan earlier in the video, so you can easily go back, write it all down, just put it in your MyFitnessPal. Today's workout was a really good workout. Obviously had tons of energy, and even before the workout started, I was already blowing up like vein wise like my veins were popping big time before we even started the workout. The workout was great. We didn't get much clips because we were so dialed in, but from the clip that you did see, that where I just like absolutely gave it a big pump, a big push after my chest workout, and I was just all blown out. It was like, it looked crazy, it looked freaky, like it was pretty awesome, to tell you the truth. And yeah, so I had tons of energy. One thing though that I want to not stress about, but tell you guys, if you do a refeed, that you have to be careful. And this is what Ross told me as well, and it is true because I'm experiencing it right now. You get these really crazy hunger cravings. Like normally on my regular days, on my high fat days, I'm not really like, I can control my hunger. Like I'm like, I'm not really hungry, I can wait. Well, today, after every meal, I was like, okay, like 30 minutes, an hour would pass. I'm like, okay, where's my next meal? Like I'm hungry, like I need to eat again. And I remember like, it was like 12 o'clock and I normally don't have my, obviously I don't have my pre-workout meal till 3. And it was 12, I'm like, dude, I'm super hungry. Like, I'm ready to eat again. Like, let's go. I had my meal at 9, then I had my meal at 11. And by 12, I'm like, dude, I need to eat again. And I'm not gonna lie, it was very hard to like maintain it and just like tell yourself, like, Logan, like, calm down, you're not hungry. It's just that feeling you have. This is what happens when you eat carbs. Your body constantly wants more. Your body's just like soaking it up and just sending you like more, give me more, give me more. So that is something that you absolutely have to be careful about. Try to stay busy. I try to stay busy, get some work done, try to get my mind off food, because it was a struggle for sure. So that's one thing that I will say about a refeed day. Your craving for more carbs is definitely gonna be high, so be very careful. But other than that, I feel pretty good, guys. The food, again, I don't think, like, after like calculating the macros, I didn't calculate them, but after going over the food in my head, it wasn't like a high calorie day. If you really think about it, it really wasn't. It was actually probably pretty low. If I had to tell you the truth, it wasn't like it was a lot of food. But I feel good. Tomorrow's gonna be interesting, so I am gonna film tomorrow as well. That will be a separate video because I think I'm already editing this video. We're like at 20 plus minutes, so I do apologize if you've made it this far. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I know you guys are very, very busy. So I am gonna film tomorrow and show you everything I'm eating tomorrow because it's gonna be a completely, completely different meal plan. As you guys know, Ross already explained why he's doing that, and we also have a workout tomorrow, so maybe we can film that as well. And then tomorrow's video, or the next video tomorrow, I'll start off in the morning and show you my poses. So I'm wondering how I'm gonna look tomorrow. Like, will I be bigger? Will I be fuller? Will I be veinier? How I look with 150 grams of white rice with every single meal instead of being like depleted, no carbs, pretty moderate fat, high protein. So, which I think I look pretty decent in the mornings. Like, obviously today's, like this morning's video, I think I look pretty decent, but we'll see how I look. See if you see a difference in tomorrow's video or the next video after this, guys. So anyways, thank you for watching. If you guys have any questions on like a refeed day, high carb day, let me know in the comments below. Ross always checks these videos as well. So if you want to like write a message to him, I'm sure he'll see it and he'll answer it as well. But as always, guys, I absolutely love you, and we'll see you on the next video. Peace. Boom.